coffee stir straw. You might have to tilt your bottle a little bit to get it down in the water. But try that. So this is the most resistance you can get in these semi-occluded exercises. The tiniest straw with the water. So it's a really, it's great. I think it's a fantastic exercise and I can talk about it more. But any questions on that? Any thoughts on that? It's a great tool. I love it. So to wrap up, we've talked about illness, we've talked about hydration, we've talked about assessment and recovery, but let's think about perspective, okay? How would you handle this as a vocalist, as a student, as a professional singer? What are some things that you're gonna do if you get sick and you have to work? Anything you can think of? So what did we talk about before? If you're sick, what do you wanna do?
Water.
Sleep, absolutely. We wanna use the assessment tools that we talked about, okay? What about if you are a studio teacher? Now, studio teachers don't answer yet. But let's say in the future, you're teaching voice yourself. What might be some things you think about? If you have a student who comes in or a student who emails you and says, I'm sick, what's your first reaction? Any thoughts?
I don't want to say anything.
Well, if they were in person, then I guess it would be to see if, like what you said, if the student feels, if it seems like they feel different about their phonating and how their routine is going, like in the lesson.
Yep, absolutely. Would you ask them how long they have felt symptoms?
Yeah.
Because what would that tell you?
How, like what level or what part of the illness they might be in, whether it's the gestation period or
Yeah, so if they're still in that early part, what's the risk there?
That they're contagious.
Bingo. So studio teachers, do you have protocol for when a student is sick? Anybody want
to?
What's that? Just two?
I used to.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Any points that you like, you reserve the right to do anything when they're sick?
I reserve the right to, when they're, particularly the first year or so, to have them come in and I assess whether they can have a lesson or not.
Right, mm-hmm. Right.
Because a lot of times, you know this, that you have to sing when you're under the weather, and sometimes it's a teachable moment.
Yeah,
where
absolutely.
They can learn to manage their voice and get a paycheck.
Yeah, absolutely. And then there are other
question,
you know.
Is, would you sing if you had to, if you would you sing in this lesson if you were getting paid to be here?
Right, exactly. And the other question, the other side of that is, if they are contagious and they walk into your studio, what do you do?
Get out.
Yes.
Well, that's what I used to.
Yeah.
My basic policy is that I want to hear them. But I also take into account whether I'm singing professionally anytime soon and how scared I am of being sick.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But then beyond that, also what my schedule is and how easy is it or difficult is it to reschedule that lesson.
Yeah.
So unfortunately, that all kind of plays.
Yeah, Lucas.
This might be semi-cynical, but I feel like there's also the element of, I didn't learn my repertoire today.
Well, yes.
You know, so
yeah, exactly.
Those are just more
entirely. Yeah, exactly. So, and there
they've come in prepared before, you know.
Right. So we're operating on the honor system here, that, you know, if someone is sick, they're saying they're sick and that they are. So, but as a teacher, You want to think about these things in the futures. I'm not talking to the students particularly right now. So not only think about how are you going to handle this if you are the one that's sick, but what if it's a student of yours that is sick? Okay, so one final question. What if you are a choral director? If you've been in choir and you've been sick, what happens? Yeah. Oh,
so. Yeah, I mean, she was saying, everybody gets sick.
Right.
I don't know that this was effective or not, but for a while when we were having really intense repertoire that we were learning, we really needed people to be in rehearsals to absorb the sounds.
Right.
You had like a quarantine quarter
yep.
of all the people who still
sick
needed to be there, but they
Yep, absolutely. I know.
I'm
keen. I don't know how that works because everybody's still kept getting sick.
Right.
So.
Yeah. I mean, I've sung with the Chicago Symphony Chorus, Grant Park Festival Chorus, and those are professional choruses, and they're also union choruses, so you are required to be there, and you may or may not have paid sick days. But both organizations have sick bay, and it's basically just a spot in the back of the room where you follow along. So that is an option. So let's say you have a student who's contagious, is running a fever, but it's an important rehearsal. What's an option for that student? Any thoughts? How they can catch up?
Recording, having a recording.
Yeah, recording is an option. Skype could be an option. Gosh, I love the 21st century. Skype has like changed our lives. Something that Symphony Chorus does is they have, I think it was like the assistant chorus manager will send out rehearsal notes. So if there are things that have been changed, like phrasing, dynamics. So if you're sick and the ensemble doesn't have something in place like that, maybe contact a friend who's in choir and ask them very, very nicely if they would provide some rehearsal notes for you. And if you are a choir director, that's something that you can think about if you have students who do need to know what's going on. So as we think about vocal health in these terms, we want to think about not only ourselves, but also once we leave this institution, how are we going to manage this when we're out working, when we're teaching, and just out and about. So any questions? I know we're a little over time. Yeah.
How do you feel about taking prednisone when you're, or
steroids? Yeah. So steroids. Yeah. If you can avoid taking them, avoid taking them. I've had to take them a few times myself. I know how they affect me, and it's not fun. The thing with prednisone and steroids, sometimes you have to take those to get over really severe illnesses, or you may have to take them regularly. The problem is they give you a false sense of health. And so you will feel like, I feel like $1 million right now. I'm just gonna sing like I usually do. Then you may be setting yourself up for injury and not realize it. The other thing is coming down off of prednisone. I was in a dress rehearsal one time and almost passed out because I was like on my last pill of the pack. And it's no good. If you can avoid it, I personally recommend it, but again, talk to your doctor. Any other questions? That's a great question. Yeah. Anything else? You guys have been really great. Thanks so much. I really appreciate you. If you want to take extra straws, please do. And then we've got 3 extra bottles of water if you're thirsty.